You are already aware that health insurance essentially covers hospitalization expenses. But are all kinds of hospitalizations covered under health insurance? That's what we will discuss today. For a hospitalization to be covered under health insurance, it has to meet a certain specific criteria. And there are three such criteria that it has to meet. First, a medical practitioner, a doctor, has to officially recommend that you need to get hospitalized, or your relative or your family member needs to get hospitalized. So in case, let's say I am feeling heavy in the chest and I go to the hospital and I get checked, and the doctor says that okay, there's nothing to worry and you can go home, here are some pills, take them and you don't need to get hospitalized. But my family members, they say that okay, no, we want Mahavir to get hospitalized, and they insist that a hospitalization happens. That is not going to get covered under health insurance. A hospitalization that is not recommended by a doctor, by a medical practitioner, is not covered under health insurance. Second, the treatment should basically confirm the standards, the global standards of medical treatment globally and in the medical community in India. What does this basically mean? Just because a doctor recommends a hospitalization, which may not be really the protocol followed by the medical community in the country, it may not be covered by health insurance in India. Let me give you an example, right? Meaning the same example is that I am feeling very heavy in the chest, but my ECG is normal, my blood pressure is normal, but let's say the doctor decides, even for such cases where I have nothing wrong, none of my medical tests showing anything negative, the doctor decides to get me hospitalized, properly in the inpatient department of the hospital. This is not usual, and this is not what is confirming global standards, right? Global standards protocols. It does not even follow, what would have been followed by the medical community in the country. In such cases, an insurance company may take a call to not pay you the claim, even if a doctor has recommended the hospitalization, right? So it's not that this is a very rare case, but this is basically to avoid any kind of nexus happening between a doctor and a patient, where both of them decide that let's cash in the to the hospitalization insurance or a health insurance that I own or someone owns, and make a claim, right? So this is basically to avoid that. It's a very, very rare case, but you need to be aware of this kind of a case or this kind of a situation also, that a doctor recommending a hospitalization that does not confirm the global standards is not going to be covered under health insurance. Third, and the most important thing that is important for a hospitalization to be covered under health insurance, is that it should involve active line of treatment. It may sound very jargonish to people when I say this word, but it actually means something very, very simple. It basically means that if you are in the hospital, the hospitalization should involve actual medical management. It should involve you, going through certain treatments that could have been carried out only in a hospital. If there is the treatment that you're getting in the hospital could have been carried out at your house, or let's say in an OPD center, or it did not involve any kind of very, very active monitoring, it did not involve any kind of active treatment, it won't be covered under health insurance. So for example, I have had this case where a lady who was 75 year old, her son had bought a policy for her a long back, and she basically was not feeling well, and there was cancer detected right while she was in the hospital, right? So there were a lot of diagnostic tests that were done on on her, which basically unfortunately detected cancer. Now she was 75 years old, right? And there was no treatment that was done. There were only tests that were done on her. And because she was 75 years old, the doctor recommended that, okay, because she's quite old, she's quite fragile, so there's no meaning of she getting treated through, let's say, any kind of cancer treatment. It's better that she goes home, rests at her house, and you know, we will look at this maybe later, but right now, because she's very fragile and she's quite old, she should not be hospitalized. In this case, what happened is that the person was hospitalized. She was hospitalized. This lady was hospitalized. She went through medical test, but she did not actually go through any kind of treatment. And hence, this claim was declined by the insurance company. And rightly so, because an insurance policy, a health insurance policy, only covers active line of treatment. So whenever anybody gets hospitalized, if there is an active treatment that gets carried out, which is the case, 99% of the cases would involve active line of treatment. 99% of the cases would be recommended by a doctor. Most of the cases would follow medical protocols, global medical protocols, or the Indian medical protocols. So there is nothing to worry about, but it's important for you to have this clarity so that there are no confusions, no doubts in your mind, and that's what we are here to solve for. I hope you like this video and it helped you get better clarity about what is covered in a hospitalization and how and what kind of hospitalizations are covered and not covered. In case you have any questions, doubt, please be free to ask us these questions on the forum or write down in the comment section below, and we'll be more than happy to answer it as soon as possible. Thank you very much. Goodbye.